Hi everyone, it's been a while, it's been like a month. This is the first video of 2022, and we're starting off immediately controversial, like very controversial. Should it be controversial? No, it, in my opinion, it shouldn't. But anyways, welcome to the first video of 2022. This is gonna be kind of a weird intro because it's a disclaimer. Disclaimer, one, you probably already saw in the thumbnail, there's some pretty graphic stuff in here. If you're kind of like not with that, click off. Two, if you for some reason don't like women's rights, you should probably click off because I make fun of people just like you in this video. So, number three, I say a couple weird things, but I'm playing a character. The same character will be in next week's video, and his name's Edgar, and he wears a trench coat. So if I say some slightly strange things, like that I don't like women's rights, that is purely a character, and I say that in the video, and it's a joke. It's supposed to mock the people that I'm talking to. You'll understand in a minute. Anyways, that's about all I have to say. You know, enjoy the video. Next week, we're getting a really good video. And then a couple weeks after that, we're getting a really, really good video. So stay tuned, watch the video. This one peace. Got no light. Yeah. Laughing to the bank like ah. Yeah. Flex on swole like ah. Yeah. You feel some type of way then ah.
Uh-oh.
Hi.
How you doing?
Hey.
This is cool.
Yeah, do you do not support abortion?
Well, yeah, I was doing a documentary over there, but coincidentally, you know, this lines right up with my beliefs. I don't believe in women's rights either. So.
As in, like, the right to kill an unborn child? Is
it? Yeah. Yeah.
I agree.
So,
that's not a woman's right because
what
it's
that?
A separate book. So this is a baby.
That's a baby.
It's the face of a baby in the womb.
That's a real picture.
Mm-hmm.
And was that child aborted?
Well, I don't know if that child was, but this child was.
That's not a child.
Yes, this is absolutely a child.
That's more like a frog.
No. This is a human. This is a baby. This is a leg. This is skin. These are ribs.
It looks like a frog-like creature.
Yeah, no, that's what we look like. There's no head.
I don't know. I'm just a little confused because I don't like abortion because I hate women. but I'm just curious as to how. Like, why do you care about that?
Because it's murder. God says it's murder. We should love our neighbors ourselves.
God says it.
Yeah. Why do you hate abortion?
Huh?
Why do you hate abortion?
I don't like women. Because abortion's their right.
It's not their right.
No, there's not a right to abortion.
There's no, yeah.
I mean, I feel like there is a right to abortion. Well, it seems like you're hating on women.
That's a lie. I had an abortion.
I'll get back to you. You had an abortion.
I had an abortion and it was the biggest mistake of my life. I realized that I had murdered a human being. It wasn't me. It was a separate human being. And it's murder.
So with abortion, obviously you don't want to abort them so they have equal opportunity, right?
Well, they should have.
Yeah, they should have equal opportunity. So you don't want to abort a child because you want them to have equal opportunity.
They
as every other child, obviously, because if they are murdered, then
they have the right to life.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't care about the word opportunity.
Equal opportunity to live, right?
Right.
Well, I feel like I'm not gonna judge anybody's parenting, but I feel like you conditioning your children to hold signs outside. Or whether these are your children, I don't know, I'm assuming. I feel like that's not giving them equal opportunity to have their opinion.
No, they know the truth.
Does that look like a frog to you?
No, that looks more like a baby.
You could go and view on abortionknow.org. It's a doctor that did 12,000 abortions. He repented now, he's a Christian.
Uh-huh.
And then he has a photographer. They actually sworn an affidavit in a court that all pictures taken, all pictures right here are actually real pictures of abortions.
That's wild. Yeah, that looks more like a baby. I don't think, I mean, it's like, I don't know.
What are those? Are those frog legs?
The second one kind of looks like one. Kind of looks like a monkey leg, maybe. That kind of looks like a monkey. That might be a monkey. It might be a real picture, but it might be a monkey. I don't know.
Are you a Christian?
Huh?
Are you a Christian?
Yeah, I love God.
Who's God?
Huh?
Who's your God?
God.
God of the Bible? What God?
The one in the sky.
Who is that?
Heaven. The one in heaven.
Who says he's God? What's your absolute
standard? I said he's God. Who says your God's God?
That's what I'm saying. What's your standard to say he's God?
What's your standard to say he's God?
The Bible. That's my absolute standard.
Okay, but
because you're saying this is gross or this is wrong. Well, what makes it wrong?
I think what makes it wrong is the fact that you're not giving women a choice. Wait, no, hold up. That contradicts my belief. I hate women's rights. Sorry, I'm breaking character.
Well, actually, murdering a baby is not a woman's right.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
It's their baby. They can do what they want with it.
My kid over there, the one over here, he's 12. He came from me and my wife, so I own him, so I can kill him.
No.
Well, why not?
Well, because once he's actually out of the womb, then he has rights. Like every other person.
No. Who says that?
Well, the government.
Where's the government get the authority to say that you can kill inside the womb?
It's a law. What? You can sue the person. Anyone involved.
It's all lip service.
You can't trust what you hear the media.
It's all lip service.
You can't trust what you hear the media. No, but you can trust laws.
You're hearing it on the media.
So you're a Christian, right?
Yes, sir.
So let's say you, say your son, right? He gets a girl pregnant before they're married. That's a sin. Whoa. What are you gonna do with that baby? He's not in a place to be a father, and I'm sure the girl that he impregnated is not in a place to be a mother. So what are you gonna do in that situation? Are you gonna parent the child?
So what do you mean he's not in a place to take care of the baby?
I know.
He's a child. He's a child himself. How is he gonna take on a child?
Well, first of all,
I'm 15. I don't have the ability to take on a child.
First of all, that's a straw man argument because my children are raised in the ways of the Lord, and my 12-year-old is not gonna go do that.
All right, we'll say that. And so
after that, okay. If you go with your straw man argument, then I would say, no, you're not gonna murder. We're gonna attend the church's responsibility to call him to repentance. That he's not going to practice that anymore. That is fornication. That is wrong. And hopefully he repents. Well, no, you take care of the child.
Whoa! No. So if I get an abortion, I'm just going to repent it. And then we're all good. Me and God, we're homies.
No, that's presumptuous sin, guys.
No, what? But how's the other one not? But I thought she... Wait, so she's not repentant? Because she got an abortion, didn't she?
I am repentant.
True forgiveness.
God needs to forgive me more.
What's your name, anyways?
Huh?
Name.
My name's Edgar.
Edgar?
Yeah.
That's my brother's name.
Yeah, she has
That's a nice name.
A
I like
name.
That name. No, so I was just wondering, like, what about, like, LGBTQ people? Why don't... Does he not like them? Wait, so you say he's... LGBTQ people are sinners. Okay, so you're born... If you're gay, you're born gay. Right?
Nope, I'm gay.
That's not... Okay. No, it's not!
It is.
It's,
That's what you've been playing.
Oh, that's what I've been led to believe. Well,
there's no scientific proof that you have gay genes, sir.
Okay.
You weren't born gay, sir. It's a choice. I wasn't born married. It was a choice to marry my wife.
So if you find a guy attractive and you want to date them, then you're sinning?
Yes,
why?
Sir, that's sin.
Why?
Because God says that's an abomination.
The abominable snowman? I understand the man's supposed to love a woman and a woman's supposed to love a man, but I don't see how, like, if you just like feel like you love someone, why can't you just love them?
Because, okay, well see, what is love, yeah, first of all? What is your standard of love? Who says you should love anyone?
Your brain, it's a natural brain thing. Your brain, your own judgment.
Who tells your brain to work and do that? What does the chemical, so you're saying you're just governed by chemical reactions?
Yeah,
so who causes those chemical reactions?
My damn brain.
Who created them? You just didn't.
Not God.
So who did?
Science and evolution.
So you're saying that because of millions and billions of years ago, stardust bumped together.
Yeah, you grow consciousness.
We bump together, and eventually we through primordial slime we evolved into humans.
Yeah.
Okay. So where did you get the understanding of love? Where do you get the sense of morality? Because animals don't have the understanding. You're just a higher.
Yeah, because our brains are more advanced. We've grown to have a higher consciousness, and we can feel emotion. And love is a very strong emotion.
Who says?
What do you mean? Do you have emotions?
Who says you're right? How do you know that's even true? What's your standard to say that's absolutely true?
the fact that I can feel emotions.
How do you know that your feeling is even real? What makes it real? What's reality?
Are you arguing the fact that people have consciousness?
Yeah. I'm not saying what gives you the all knowledge and understanding to say that you're even true and you're even conscious. How do you know?
You stumped me there. I don't know.
Bible, that's the absolute truth.
I don't know if it's the absolute truth, because there's a couple opinions on it.
Yes, sir.
Getting closer to what?
Yes, sir, hopefully.
See, he told you that you're getting closer. You're saying it's still alive and well, but he just said, and you agreed with him, that we're on the way out of abortion. You make no sense.
We'll go back to that in a little bit.
Okay.
So,
thank you, sir.
I'm trying to remember what we were talking about. So you said
you were talking about how you don't really believe in consciousness.
No, I did believe in consciousness. That's not what I'm saying.
Are you arguing the fact that people have consciousness?
Yeah. From the very beginning, he created the earth. He created the world. Okay.
Did he?
Yes.
Where's this proof? A book?
Scriptures. Yes. Well, where's your proof that you exist? What's your standard? By faith, I believe.
Research
that.
And
faith
science.
Do you have it?
Your camera.
I don't have faith, dog. I got faith in myself. I'm my own guy.
Who made your camera?
Probably a sweatshop in China.
Right. So somebody had to make it, right?
Yeah, I just said that.
So you think the world just appeared out of dust?
Yeah.
Who created the dust?
I don't know. It just happened. Those are some unexplainable things. You're trying to explain some things that are pretty unexplainable
matter
here.
Matter can't be created.
Who made God? Who made God? That's what I'm saying. Huh?
God said he always existed.
Okay, well the sun always existed. The dust always existed.
That.
No, but you're messing up your own argument. You're saying who created the dust? Well, I can just argue that the dust was always there.
My
worldview was that the dust created it.
But where do you get your worldview from?
Myself? I'm my own God.
So what I'm saying
I can make
is,
it up.
So you have 350.
We're living in a simulation, dog. The world is flat.
So if I get enough people to agree with me, I can kill you. Is that okay?
No.
Who says?
Because I say so. I'm my own guy. Actually, the government says that you can't do that and get away
with
it.
That's illegal.
So are you going to kill me? Please don't kill me.
You're using moral arguments like killing and love.
Can you not kill me, please?
Those are moral arguments.
Can you just tell me that you're not going to kill me? Because I'm really scared. You're making a suggestion? Hey, yo, I got to back up. I'm just wondering, are you going to kill me, man? Can you just give me confirmation that you're not going to kill me? I'm uncomfortable.
You're the one with the trench coat, probably back with guns in there.
No, I can open it up. No, I have a shirt that says, smile if you love cats. Do you guys like cats? Do you guys like abortion?
I'm in favor for whatever a person wants to do.
Yeah!
So, like,
have you adopted kids?
Does that matter with stopping abortion?
Yeah, because what happens after they come out of the body?
How many kids
who's
do
gonna take care of them?
How many kids?
Facts.
How many kids are
on? God, why y'all trying to make more? It sounds like y'all just like having sex, dog.
How many babies do I need?
Adopt them all, man!
Exactly.
You should start an orphanage. That's what you need to do. That's what y'all need to start doing. Instead of standing out here with signs, you know, wasting your day, go do something. Make an orphanage. Own your own orphanage. Then you can harbor these children that were not aborted. I'm a genius. See, she's even laughing. She thinks I'm good. No, but instead, you guys should stop making babies and start harboring the children.
God says babies are a blessing of the Lord. We don't need to kill them. We need.
I'm not saying to kill them, dog. I'm saying that there's ones that are struggling in orphanages. Make your own orphanage, and then no babies are suffering. God, I am so smart. No, but they're not being murdered because they don't have consciousness.
Who says?
It's science, dog.
How do you know science is real and true?
Oh my God, if you are arguing about how science is real, I'm not.
But I'm saying, what makes it real? Who says that? You're not the absolute,
you're not all-knowing.
How do you know?
Because
I can know everything.
The Bible says no one's all-knowing except for him.
What's my
age? No, but how does
how
the-
How old am I? How old am I?
47. Well, you look like it. How old are you?
I'm 45, so you don't know everything.
Well, I was close. Round down. Huh.
All right, man, have a good day, man.
No, I want to continue talking, please.
Nah.
Why not?
You're mocking and scoffing.
I'm not mocking anybody.
Okay.
No, okay, so I have a question. If your child came out as gay, what are you going to do then?
My child came out gay. Well, babies are not born gay.
Well, but what if they decided they want to be gay?
The Bible says for me to teach my children in the laws of the Lord and the scriptures, and then after that, whatever is their decision, but I don't have the right to murder them, and I don't know the future anyway, because nobody's born gay.
Okay, so you're saying that if they choose to go, let's say they choose to go gay, what are you going to do? Are you going to be like, I hate you?
No, I'll tell them they need to repent.
You're going to love the kid, so you don't like gay people, but you're going to love your gay child. You don't like gay people, and now one of your kids could be gay, and you're still gonna like them? I don't get that.
Who said I didn't like gay people? Who said that?
Yeah, he never said he didn't like gay people.
Okay.
You put words in my mouth.
No, but you're saying that it's a sin to be gay, but you can't repent for the damn sin because you're gay. Can I repent and still be gay?
No.
Why?
Not true.
I want to love men. I love men.
Yeah, well, you're an abomination.
I'm an abominable snowman?
We're done talking because you're scoffing and I'm not going to pass.
I'm not scoffing. I'm thinking. This is how my brain works. This is how my brain works. Hey, don't stop my brain working.
All right.
Do you have a bad relationship with your parents?
Huh? I love my parents.
And they're okay with you being gay?
I'm not gay, but they're cool with it. They don't really care. Probably because we're not religious. See, I feel like...
We're not religious either.
What? You just said you're a Christian.
I have a relationship with Christ, but doesn't religion is religious man-made.
So you can believe in God and not be religious?
Exactly.
Yo, that's crazy. I'm an atheist, and that's how I've been raised to be. So you can raise your children however you'd like. You could say that my parenting is bad, or that my parents' parenting is bad. But, nah, I'm an atheist, and, like, I feel like that's a lot more accepting. Because, like, if you think about it, if my parents... Let's say I'm gay, right? If my parents are cool with me being gay, then why would I want to be a Christian if I'm not allowed to be me? How do we even know that heaven and hell's real?
How do you know that you're came from monkeys?
Well, because I like monkeys. They're cute.
You didn't answer my question. How do you know that we had explosion and we evolved from primordial slime? Were you there?
I mean, I could have been. I don't really remember if I was. I might have been.
No,
let's agree to disagree. Let's agree.
I have more evidence for what I believe than it was.
You have a book.
Look at creation. God says in Romans
the book of creation. Facts. All you had to do was slap the creation on there. Now you got my attention. No, I don't think
the complexity of your body, how it works. It has to have a creator.
So if I read a book, it's a library called Thomas the Train. Do I believe that trains are living now? I don't think so, because trains are not living. Trains are inanimate objects.
Without God, you don't even know, you can't even think, sir.
Well, but how do you know that? How do we know anything? So we're agreeing to different beliefs. No, are we agreeing to disagree?
By faith.
Are we agreeing to disagree?
I'm not agreeing, there's no
disagreement. You're not agreeing with me? Oh my God, you're so not accepting. Man, you're really messing up my brain here, because I'm thinking.
That's good. You need to open up your brain.
My brain is completely open. You guys are closed-minded. You guys are closed-minded because you don't like gay people.
Nobody, we never said we don't like gay people.
You don't accept gay people.
It's gonna destroy you.
What?
Get out of it.
What's gonna destroy me?
The practice of sodomy.
What is that?
You know
homosexuality.
What it is.
I don't know. Oh.
Don't play stupid.
I'm not homosexual.
Yeah, you are.
I could be if I. What? You're calling me gay? I could be if I wanted to.
Well, anybody could be anything. That they
exactly.
Want to
be. So you're accepting. I like you. High five.
I'll give you a high five.
Boom.
You can be a lot of things that are evil.
Well, I don't want to be evil. I just want to like men.
Then you're homosexual.
So that makes me evil?
You're in sin.
I have no evil intentions.
That's an abomination.
No, I love cats. Smile if you love cats. I love cats. How can I be evil? Facts.
Yeah, that's facts. She has nothing to back up what she even said. All right, man, well, have a good day, bro.
Wait, but can we talk about abortion more?
We're standing here for our preborn neighbor, to love our neighbors himself that Jesus commands us to do. To love our neighbor, stand up.
Did Jesus tell you to do this?
Yes, he does.
Oh, my God, I need to have a long talk with Jesus. Do you have his phone number? I need to talk to
him. When your neighbor is being...
Okay, but can I talk to him? I
want
to talk to him. I want to talk to... I need to have a sit-down talk with him. I need to scold him. What do you guys think?
He's just mind-boggled over there from what you're saying.
Oh, his mind's boggled because of what I'm saying. Not because of the signs that have frog legs and monkey bodies.
That's actually the babies that have been murdered.
That's not babies. That's a monkey. That's a frog. That's a monkey leg. What is that one about?
Yeah, that's one of this color.
Yeah, like, what does that have to do with?
Yeah, that is that a child?
Every age. So there was a time when slavery was considered legal and okay. And we would have been those people that were fighting that. Abolitionists, those abolitionists at those times.
You're comparing yourself to someone who fought for slavery? What? I am shocked. The children are enslaved, dog. The children aren't thinking.
That was not a choice.
Facts.
It's all evil. It's all wicked. So whatever.
So you're putting
this is not a choice.
Not a choice. That was forced. Something that was.
Is it the baby's choice though?
Yeah.
To be
this
killed?
Is not a choice.
It's not a choice. It's the mother's choice that's been convinced by the devil.
But the baby don't even know what's going on. The baby's dumb.
The baby's not dumb.
Yes, it is. What? Did you say that baby's not dumb?
God
He looks pretty dumb.
Yeah. What we're saying is that, you know, slaves said they had no rights, they were mere property. Well, this is what they're saying today. The baby's in my body, it's my property. I can do whatever I want.
He said he hates gay people.
My wife
so like the, so like
she said if I was gay, I'd go to hell.
So like the regulating of slavery, they did that.
Well, but then you relayed the message. No, I'm wondering why you guys hate me because I'm gay.
We don't hate
you. Well, not gay.
We don't hate you. We don't hate anybody.
No. Man, I like that. I like you. You're my favorite. Another high five.
What?
Boom.
Because you keep changing your story. You told us over there that you are against abortion. Because
oh, yeah. No, that was a character I was playing. Now I'm not. No, I'm not in that character anymore.
But you should use your energy towards doing good and not evil.
What? I'm doing great, dog. Like, now I'm understanding the scale of these pictures is the issue. That's why that one looks so scary, and that's you're, but you guys are fear mongering. But that's why that one looks so scary.
You see the five fingers that look just like my hand?
No, I understand that, but you can say that about most things. You could kill a monkey and say,
no, but a monkey has a whole different hand structure than our hand.
Not really, it's pretty similar. No. But how big is that? What's the scale of this? How upscaled is this?
This baby is probably what? 9 weeks or something right here, I'm thinking, so.
Nine weeks, that's so nothing.
You're talking about a baby about this.
Oh yeah, that big, that's nothing, I could. So I don't care that much.
They will regret it. The mothers will regret it. If they don't regret it, they're bound for hell. You know, we are not fighting just for
no,
the babies.
I don't think a lot of mothers regret it. A lot of mothers, it's kind of the best decision of their life because they don't have to deal with a child at the age of 14.
Have you ever talked to every single, you haven't talked to every mother.
I mean, I've talked to one who had an abortion. She was pretty cool.
Yeah, unfortunately, a lot of people are convinced and that doesn't mean that it's right. It's still wrong. It's
what is hell?
Hell is where we go for eternity.
But do I feel it? Because I'm dead. Because I'm dead, so do I feel the burning?
So hell is the absence of everything that is good. Anything, love, all the good.
Well, yeah, but I'm dead, so I can't feel it anyways. My brain doesn't work.
You will feel it. You'll suffer for eternity.
How do you know? Have you been to hell?
The Bible speaks of hell.
Oh my God, the Bible says it, but this book was written thousands of years ago.
Well, you're asking people that actually truly believe the Bible.
That's true.
So you can't get a different answer out of us.
I like you. You know, you're cool too. High five?
I don't know if I'm cool. Why do you want to, how about a low five?
Okay, I like that.
Okay,
I don't like him. He's mean. He hates gay people.
No, he doesn't hate gay people. He's actually the most loving because he's actually telling the full truth regardless of who. You know,
I guess he's cool. She's not cool. She said I was going to hell for being gay.
No, she's telling you the truth too.
No, you relayed the message.
It is true.
Take the messenger, not the book,
lady. No. You will go to hell if you are gay. You also go to hell if you are an adulterer.
Hold up, high five again. I'm taking it back. I'm taking back the high five because you said I was going to hell.
Okay, so what is it that you do? Becoming a cinematographer or what?
I'm 15. I got a YouTube channel. Yeah.
Very cool.
I guess you could say that I'm at an impressionable age.
Yes.
But because I am God, you can't impressionalize me. Our own thing. I'm gonna go talk to her real quick and then I'm gonna get out of y'all's hair.
Okay. Alright, Egon. We'll be praying for you.
What's up? How you doing?
Not much. I'm finding there's a documentary where they're performing an abortion. I want you to see it.
Ooh.
An ultrasound.
Okay.
You said the babies don't feel things or see things. You need to see this.
All right. I'd be interested
in
that.
It
sounds kind of gross, though. I don't know if I want to watch that.
Well, why not? If it's just monkeys and
I'm a little squeamish.
Toads. Man up.
Hey, don't tell me to man up. I am a man. You're still mean. I'm not.
I don't play this silly little game.
I understand.
This is babies' lives.
I understand.
This is important. This is murder. Just like if someone was trying to murder you, I wouldn't be silly and joking about it.
I get
You're making fun of the babies.
I get it. No, I get
calling
it.
Calling them toads.
I get it.
And monkeys. These are babies.
I understand what you're saying.
Murdered.
I'm just saying. Hey, I'm
and
leaving.
And I would defend you the same
I'm leaving.
Way. I defend you the same way if someone's trying to harm you.
I appreciate that.
It's consistency.
I appreciate that. Still not going to give you a high five because you told me I'm going to hell. I took back her high five. You relayed the message. Hate the messenger, not the book. That's my motto. I took back my high five. I like him still. Bye-bye.
See you later, Edgar.
And then I...